Welcome back. I do believe this is the most exciting segment I've had so far, and it's a great honor for me to interview our next guest, Amy Osmond Cook, who you all know and love as my co-host here on Good Day Orange County, is an amazing performer, businesswoman, mother, just Renaissance woman for all ages. She does it all, and she does it all with grace and style, and I so appreciate her for that. And Amy is our featured guest today for our Women in Business series, because Amy also owns and runs Osmond Marketing. So we're gonna talk and learn from Amy here today. I'm so glad you're here with us.
You're so sweet. Thank you so much, Lauren. You are just so sweet. And I feel the same way about you. And I interviewed you 2 months ago for this as well. It's such an exciting time to be a woman, don't you think?
A woman, and a woman in public space, mm-hmm. a woman in business, I mean, doing this kind of thing. Mm-hmm. It's also a really interesting time to be an entrepreneur.
It is.
And you qualify on all levels in all of those areas. So tell us a little bit. I know you've been performing since you were three.
Yes.
So give me a little background.
Okay. Thank you. Okay, so my first gig was when I was 3 years old, and I was Little Marie Osmond in a movie called
Side by Side.
You remember, and I didn't remember. I was like, what was that movie called? And anyway, it was so much fun. I loved every moment of it. And then I started performing with my family, mm-hmm. and I performed throughout high school. We were in the Osmond Family Theater together.
And that was in Branson.
In Branson, Missouri. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And then I ended up being the national spokesperson for a program called America's Junior Miss, which I loved. It was fantastic. So I did that my freshman year of college, and then I actually kind of had a little bit of an existential crisis because I thought, you know, this is the family business to go into show business. But I didn't have a lot of confidence that I could be the next Marie. Like, there's really only one Marie,
there
you
is.
Know? And so I thought, I don't know if I could make it in the business. I have a lot of other interests in school, and I wanted to settle down and get married and have a family, and that lifestyle didn't lend itself as well to it. Mm-hmm. And so I thought, okay, well, I'm just gonna go to school. And it's just funny how things happen, because I never really had any ambitions to run a business or to get a PhD or whatever. And life just happens, and you just never know what's gonna happen from it, right?
Sure.
So I got married when I was in college, and I wasn't married when I got through college the first time, so I thought, oh, well, you know, this is a good place to find a guy. I'll just stick around and do my grad work. And so I got married, and we had two kids, and then we ended up getting divorced when my first husband was in medical school. Mm-hmm. And so I moved back home with my parents, and I thought, well, now what do I do? Now I have two children to support, right. And I don't know what to do, because I graduated in English. And anyway, so I thought, well, I think I'll just go back to school, because that would be a great job to be a professor, and I could, you know.
So to go back to teach
this time. To go back to teaching, it'd be mm-hmm. a good flexible job for my kids. And so I decided to do that. And then as I was finishing my degree, I got married for a second time. And I thought, oh, this is great, because my husband was in finance, and he had just gotten this great job with Lehman Brothers, which was this amazing investment banking company. And then the bottom fell out of the finance market.
Sure did.
Right? So I thought, well, now what am I going to do? And so it was partly as a way to, you know, show Jeff how much I loved him, because he really sacrificed a lot of his career opportunities to stay in Orange County, where our children were, because that's where our custody agreement was. Mm-hmm. And so he chose our family over his career, which I will just always love and respect and admire him so much for. And I thought, okay, well, I really need to start helping provide, you know, because Lehman Brothers has just gone bankrupt. Jeff just lost his job. We've got to do something. So that's when I started Osmond Marketing. And it just started out as a mom job. I had two older children, and I had two little babies, and I was pregnant with a third, and I was like, we've got to figure out a way to do this. And so we got so lucky. And one of the best connections that I have made is one of our best friends together, mm-hmm. Cheryl Snap Connor. And Snap Connor PR really helped us a lot to get started, and we continue to have a great relationship with that fabulous PR team. And so as we just, you know, it's just funny how where you find yourself, because I find myself now just enjoying so much the entrepreneurship lifestyle and running a business. And being part of something bigger and better and greater than myself and making all these amazing connections, but it only happened out of, you know, necessity because sure. I, you know, didn't know what else I was going to do, so.
But you asked the right questions and you came mm-hmm. to good answers. Mm-hmm. So tell us about Osmond Marketing. What exactly do you do?
So Osmond Marketing is a full service marketing company and it is a wonderful experience. So I'm the founder and then Jeff is, my husband Jeff is the CFO and then our good friend Emily is the COO and she kind of takes care of all the day-to-day stuff. We have five core competencies. We do content, PR, design, web services, and we're Google partners, and so we run the Google G Suite. We resell email, we help people get set up on their business system. And so we do that for a number of companies, and we come in with, I mostly focus on the strategic side, mm-hmm. and then Emily runs the day-to-day operations, but it allows us to be able to pretty much serve whatever needs businesses have. And so our model is very interesting because we try to come in at a price point where it's more convenient for people to just outsource their marketing mm-hmm. than to get a short-term strategic service and then bring it in-house.
Got it.
So for us, our price point is about half of what other agencies charge, but it is just the right amount. So we don't take a lot of profit from our strategic services, but it's just enough that it keeps us in business and it helps other companies develop long-term relationships.
So you're basically building a rainstorm of mm-hmm. smaller drops.
That's exactly right.
Instead of just the big buckets.
That's absolutely right. And so that's a different model from other agencies. And I feel like in some ways we've fixed what has been broken about mm-hmm. the agency model. And I really am grateful to be able to do that. And it's given me the opportunity to meet some really amazing people.
I bet it has.
Yeah.
And it also sounds like you've taken great advantage of where things are in the world right now, meaning working with other professionals remotely, mm-hmm. not needing to have everybody local in-house, not mm-hmm. as much brick and mortar, mm-hmm. allows you to keep expenses down.
That's right. And it allows us to source the best talent mm-hmm. everywhere, which is really amazing. So the company has 13 full-time employees and then about 40 contractors that go between 20 to 40 hours a week. And so this allows us to be part of the gig economy mm-hmm. that everyone's been talking about. We have extended full-time offers to many people who have said, I would rather just do a gig.
Wow.
I will work with you for 35 hours a week, but I want to have my own time mm-hmm. and I want to be able to be independent, and we respect that. And I really admire that. And one of the reasons I think that we've been able to grow so quickly is because I respect the job of a woman, whether it's, you know, a mom or another nurturer or mm-hmm. caregiver. And so you will find amazing people who can't do a full-time job
right.
because of other life circumstances, but yet they are amazing, very, very professional and experienced, and they just...
You're giving them an opportunity.
Yeah. So, and it works great. Out very well.
So we've got 2 minutes left, and I've got two more questions.
Okay.
Number one, what is the most fun project you've worked on?
Well, it's all the SnapConner projects,
okay.
absolutely.
Of course.
So that actually
Let's
is
Let's just have
true.
That recorded.
That actually is true. For me, it's all about the people that I work with.
Mm-hmm.
So.
And then what's the biggest lesson you've learned in running a business?
Oh, the biggest lesson that I have learned is that I make mistakes every day. And because I make mistakes every day, I need to allow our team to have a very safe space to be able to say, I made a mistake, help me fix this. And so that allows us to catch things really early on and bring on other experienced people onto the team so we provide the very best level for our clients. It really allows us to keep from working in silos, and it allows us to make sure those mistakes are small and easily correctable.
So if our viewers either need marketing services, mm-hmm. need a website, need, you know, information about Osmond Marketing or anything that you could help them with, where would we find you?
Well, thank you for asking. You can always catch me on Good Day Orange County.
Oh, yes.
Or you could go to osmondmarketing.com. So Jason Osmond is my cousin. He's our director of business development. He's always on the line if you want to live chat him. Or you can reach out by phone or just amy@osmondmarketing.com.
So folks, if you have questions about Amy, about Osmond Marketing, about Donnie and Marie, about the rest of her family.
I'd love to answer Donnie and Marie questions. I actually have lots of information.
Anything you'd like to know, Amy is a font of information, and she's awfully fun when she's answering your questions too. So definitely look her up, and we'll be right back.